So today I'm going to deliver the last lecture of demography. We have covered demography in total 8 lectures, and you have been doing many numericals associated with demography. It is very, very important from examination point of view, and it's a chance that you will get 2 or 3 questions in SEQs from the demography, and almost 10 to 12 MCQs from demography in your final exams. So moving forward with the fertility rates, we have discussed in our last lecture the fertility rates, which comprised of the crude birth rate, general fertility rate, total fertility rate, general marital fertility rate, total marital fertility rate, age specific fertility rate, and we will move forward from those fertility rates to the next fertility rate. So as we have discussed, age specific fertility rates, these are calculated in the specific age groups of the female population, and it actually is calculated by keeping the total number of live births in the numerator and the mid-year females of specific age group in the denominator, which gives us age specific fertility rate. When we calculate age specific fertility rates for each age specification between 15 to 49 years of age group, then we sum up all of them and multiply by 5 to get the total fertility rate. Why do we calculate it and multiply it with 5? Because for each band, the age specific fertility rate is calculated for a total 5-year span. So while calculating the age specific fertility rate, we multiply it with, we sum all the total amounts of fertility rates for different age groups, and we multiply them by 5 to get the total fertility rate, which represents the average number of children a woman would bear. If we multiply the total fertility rate, if we calculate the total fertility rate only on the basis of the female newborns, then we get the gross reproduction rate. So gross reproduction rate is actually the average number of girls that would be born to a woman of reproductive age group if she experiences the current fertility pattern through her reproductive span, assuming no mortality. Let me highlight few things which are important while calculating the gross reproduction rate. Number one, in gross reproduction rate, we are concerned with not the total number of live births, but we are concerned with the average number of girls which are born. So the total number of live births which are female will be included in the numerator. Then the denominator contains all the women between the reproductive age group of 15 to 49 years of age group. So while calculating the total fertility rate, if we do not calculate the total fertility rate on the basis of total number of live births, and we keep only the female girls born to women of reproductive age group, we will be calculating gross reproduction rate. In gross reproduction rate, a woman passes through the age pattern following the fertility pattern of that country. And the one most important thing is that we, while calculating the gross reproduction rate, we assume that there is no mortality. It means that no live birth has ended up into death. So this is the method to calculate the gross reproduction rate. But there is another measure of the fertility rate, which is known as net reproduction rate. The net reproduction rate is calculated. Now you have to know the difference between gross reproduction rate and net reproduction rate. The net reproduction rate is again the number of daughters which are born. So while comparing gross reproduction rate and net reproduction rate, we know that in both the rates we are concerned with the number of daughters which are born. But in gross reproduction rate, these daughters are born to the women of reproductive age group. In net reproduction rate, we are concerned about the number of daughters which a newborn girl will bear during her lifetime, assuming fixed age-specific fertility and mortality rates. Again, there is a difference that in gross reproduction rate, we do not assume mortality rates, but in net reproduction rate, we bring into consideration the total mortality rate. Net reproduction rate is actually the rate, which means it indicates that the total replacement level fertility. For example, if a couple, a male and a female, produces two children, out of these, one is male and the second is female, then we assume that the net reproduction rate is equal to one. It means that every girl is producing one girl, which will be replacing her. So if the net reproduction rate is equal to one, then the replacement level fertility is obtained. For example, if there is one generation, we have the net reproduction rate of three. It means this newborn girl will produce three more girls in one generation. And then these three girls in turn in second generation will again, each of them will produce three girls, because we are considering the net reproduction rate is equal to 3. So my question to you is that what will be the count of girls in the third generation if the net reproduction rate is 3? Please count. Okay. Another measure of fertility is the calculation of child-women ratio. The child means the number of children between 0 to 4 years of age group, and this constitutes 4 years, 11 months, and 29 days. So actually, this is the children under 5 years of age group, to per 1,000 women of childbearing age group between 15 to 45 years. If there is the numerator is children and the denominator is females of reproductive age group, so it is a ratio. It's not a rate, it's not a proportion. So child-women ratio is again an indication of the fertility rate of a country. Then the pregnancy rate. The pregnancy rate is calculated on the basis of number of pregnancies, which include all the live births, all the stillbirths, abortions, and all those pregnancies which are still not terminated in a year, to married women in age group between 15 to 45 or 15 to 49 years of age group. Again, it is a ratio, because as the numerator, we are keeping pregnancies, and in the denominator, we are keeping married women of age group between 15 to 49 years of age group. This pregnancy rate is totally different from calculation of the fertility rate. As you may remember that while calculating the fertility rate, we were more concerned about the total number of live births. We were not concerned about the pregnancy rates. We were not concerned about the abortion rates and stillbirth. Why it was so? Because most of the pregnancies are not reported. But while calculating specifically the pregnancy rates, we calculate all the reported, booked and unbooked pregnancies, in which can end up in live births, stillbirths, abortions, and if they are still continued. The stillbirths are all the deaths of the fetuses after 28 weeks of gestation. Abortion means the deaths of the fetus between 24 to 28 weeks of gestation. And this will constitute a ratio. It is misnomer, and it is taken as pregnancy rate. Actually, it is a pregnancy ratio. So going towards another fertility indicator, which is the abortion rate, which calculates the number of all types of abortions usually per 1,000 women of childbearing age group. Again, it is a ratio, it's not a rate, and it is calculated in the women of reproductive age group who are married. But in developed countries, this is calculated per 1,000 women of childbearing age group. The specification of marriage is not counted there. What is abortion ratio? The abortion ratio is the number of abortions performed during a particular time period to the number of live births over the same period. This is a ratio between abortions and total number of live births. The rate was calculated as the number of abortions per 1,000 women of childbearing age group. Although the numerator and denominator are different, but the abortions are occurring in the same females of the same reproductive age group. So it is known as the abortion rate. And while calculating the abortion ratio, the ratio is taken between the number of live births to the number of abortions performed during a particular time period. Again, another indicator, marriage rate. This is the crude marriage rate. This is the total number of marriages which are registered in a year in a specific area divided by the total media population into 1,000. Again, it's a very, very crude rate because not the media population, whole population is not at the marriageable age. So it is known as the crude marriage rate. There is geriatric population, there are children under 15 years of age. So the denominator should be more specific instead of calculating it from the media population. So general marriage rate is a better rate which calculates the total number of marriages in a year divided by the total numbers of unmarried person between 15 to 49 years of age group in that year in that community into 1,000. So this is more specific and more accurate measure of fertility as compared to the marriage rate. So your last assignment is that you have to find out the socio-demographic indicators of Pakistan and you have to submit their values with references to me. And these socio-demographic indicators of Pakistan should not only include the socio-demographic indicators but also the health indicators of Pakistan. So I wish you all the luck for next 1 week, which are your spring vacations. See you after that. Thank you.